a quick word with you, so could you just oblige, please? I realise you're all excited, so am I. Right. In a few moments, this is tradition at Lyndon, Miss Fellows will come and she will speak to you. When I ask for you to stand, I would like you to stand as you always have done, and I'd like you to respect that moment. And that moment is coming fairly shortly. That's my middle name. Okay. Right, can we fade the music, please? Shh. Right, I'd like silence from everybody, please. Please, will you stand for your head teacher, Miss Fellows? What have I done now? I'm always doing something wrong. It didn't hurt last time.
That's what he says all the time. Thank you, Y11, for your good manners. Please sit down. So one day I could get used, I could actually get away with using the cane. So please behave. Nearly left now, so I'm quite okay to use it, I think. Anyway, Y11, well done, you have made it. Well, nearly. You've got a couple of hours to go, but you have made it, and you've made it true style. Absolute true style. You have been a fantastic earring, and yes, we've all said as we've gone through the year, we'll be sad to see you go, and we will be. You have led the school as senior students fantastically well, and I suppose we have to admit it, really. Yeah, we are going to miss you. We won't say it again, but we will miss you. So, moving on to August, it wouldn't be right for me if I didn't mention that dreaded day in August when it's all done and dusted and you come and pick those results up. And last year I stood here and I said to the Year 11s, we will have the best exam results ever, and we did. You have, fingers crossed, with the right amount of revision from tomorrow onwards, will smash last year's exam results. And we're looking by at least another 8-10% on top of last year. And that is down to your commitment, your hard work, and the fantastic effort you've put in over the last 12 months. So well done to each and every one of you, and I can't wait to see you all in August for those. Girls, you've got away with it. You've escaped the new skirt. But if anyone would like to purchase it and then come back in it, that would really make my day. It really would. But no, girls, you've managed to get away with the new uniform. We've had lots of celebrations this year and over the 5 years you've been here. But we've had some sad times as well. And I think this week, we would all say, it's been one of the toughest weeks that we've all faced. And there is one thing that we can say about Lyndon, and that is we stand side by side. Whatever we face, whether it's 60th anniversaries, Comenius projects, and all the celebrations that go with that, or we stand side by side with the tragic loss of a student of Tarot. I want to just leave you with three things. Three pieces of advice to take with you. Firstly, fight hard for what you believe in. Never ever give way if you believe something is right. And sometimes I've been head to head with you because you think something's right and I thought it was wrong. And the one thing is great about you lot is that you fight. And you carry on fighting, please. Secondly, never ever give up on your dreams. Do you remember that assembly I did 2 years ago when you were in year 10? It was the first assembly I did. And I said, somebody told me years ago that I would never become a teacher. I would never become a head teacher. And you were the living proof that I reached my dream. So never ever give up on your dreams, please. And finally, wherever you go, you will always take part of Lyndon with you. You will always be part of Lyndon because we are a family and we will stick together. And it doesn't matter in the future, whether it's 5 years or 10 years or 5 minutes, Lyndon will always be here for you. And you come back and you see us if ever you need us. On Tuesday, we had a tough day on Tuesday, and it's been a tough week. But left on somebody's desk, a member of staff's desk, was a poem that was written. We have no idea who wrote the poem, but I want to read it to you because this sums up what you as a year group have been like, but also what we stand for as the Lyndon family. We are all one through tough and tragedy, come hell or heaven, we are all one. Every one of us, all bound and holding a little piece of each other, connecting us in grief, in sorrow, in trouble, in mourn, in tough. We are bound together. We are one. We join all grief, mourning and sorrow. We produce willingly longevity and prosperity. We learn from our love and fighting. We learn from our times of struggling and strife. We unite and pull through. We are all one. We fight, then unite. We are family and friends. We are one. We are London. Year 11, I wish you all the very best. Enjoy today.
Thank you. So I have Brian Burke, Brian Brain out here for our members. One, two. They're like Mick Jagger. If you forgive the expression, we've got the Burke, so I needed a few brains as well to help with this. Well done, lads. There's a bunch of flowers down there, Brian, please. On your behalf, the two most popular students are going to present this fellows with these flowers. Okay, thank you, boys. Thank you, Miss Fellows. As always, brilliant. So we're going to move on. A slight change of plan, but don't worry about it. It's live. Could I have Lindsay and Shev, please, here? Thank you. Shev's not here. Right. Okay, Miss Walton's going to help me present the first awards to the Assembly. I know it's Miss Walton because I used to teach her. That's how old she is. Right, Mrs. Clark, good to see you. Oh, by the way, is Adam Walker in here? Adam Walker. Adam, these are yours, mate. Chris. That was improvised when he went in this morning. Okay, here we go. You wouldn't know, would you? By the way, for those who don't get it, if you ever hear anybody say, "What's he say?" will you let me know, please, because I'll kill them. They're Walker's crisps, so they're Adam Walker's crisps. Oh, we get it now. That's just come from the police. We'll investigate them later. Right, okay. The student most likely to be a millionaire. Nominations for this award: Lucas Jones, Tom McWillan. Tom, can you stand up, please? You're the wrong gig, mate. That's down the road. December, okay? Apparently, he's got a clause in his contract. Ooh. Never heard that one, have you? Sorry, Tom. You did get a few votes, mate. Aaron Beveridge, I'll drink to him. Kieran Panasar. However, the winner, just a minute. thought I brought some punchline. Yeah, there we are. To coin a phrase, yeah. The winner is Killian. Where are you? Just before you go, that's the start you're on anyway, okay? Enjoy. I do apologise, in the excitement I forgot to introduce my sidekick here, on drums, Mr. Brown. If he can keep up, he'll do the pants after the game, so okay. I'm going to have to sort you later, sir. Promise. Best and most popular newcomer is the next one. Okay, nominations. Nominations for this award. Maggie Breener. Shafiq. Olivia David Hickman. No booing, please. You leave the booing for me. Jack Webb. But the winner, and I have to say, this person has been knocking on my office door every day for the last 3 months just to check if that person was in the running for this. Henna. What we got there? Yeah, we've changed the order a bit, so you can have a seat for a minute. Thank you. Thank you, Mrs. Clark. I think we've got a little video now, haven't we? Just have a look at this. There you go. Pray silence, please. This is serious.
Okay, you can put that on telly, you can't see it.
Sorry.
But
You did watch some good DVDs. I'm sorry that you didn't learn anything, but sometimes, Miss J, we could laugh at Miss J, couldn't we? And we could talk about being an immigrant. I'm sorry, we could laugh at Miss D. Time. Miss M. Face.
Very good, face.
H. Sorry you didn't learn anything. And you laughed at Miss J for her. Hair is fast as well. And you laughed at me for having no hair.
Well, did.
Unfortunately, it didn't really teach you anything. But I just hope that you had a good time. And that you did enjoy coming up here. And that you don't really mind that you didn't really learn anything.
It's the way of the world.
John.
Time to make that video though, didn't they? Right, here we go. Are we on the next lot now? Mr. Spur, is it the next lot? Next award is person most likely to be famous, is that right? Person most likely to be famous, okay. Nominations for this award, Brandon Beanham, Nathan Lodge, hang on a minute. Rajan, where are you? Stand up, please. Rajan. Yeah, just come out here. Something's just crossed my mind, sir. You ready with the drums, sir? They might not get this. They might be too young for this. Rajan is dressed as an Apache Indian. I've got my reservation tonight. Just thought that one. Not bad. Moving on. Where was I? Nomination. Dan Ralston. No. Nominations. I'll print you a certificate, Dan Ralston. Molly Durand. Galen Hamilton. Sinead. Ready, Mr. Brown? And Mr. Finn. I got one vote. I think it was me who filled the form. Right. Mrs. Williams, would you like to just come out and hold these for me? Because I'm a nervous wreck this morning. Nothing's going right. The winner is the person most likely to be famous, Alana Jones. Give us a quick dance, go on. Right, we'll do it together, come on. No good for the arthritis, I'll tell you. No good whatsoever. This piano's behind me, it's getting all keyed up. Right. The loudest girl. Nominations. Shh. Please respect the loudest girl by being silent. The loudest girl. Nominations are Melissa Rowan. Becca Boswell. Rhys Amos. Ryan Brain. And Ryan Burke. Everywhere that Burke went, Brain was sure to go. Anyway. Luna. Another topper. But the winner by an overwhelming minority. Sorry, majority. Who do you think? Go on, Suffer, get out here. That's quieting you down, isn't it? Right, where are we now? Loudest boy. Loudest boy. You got the right one there? Yeah, that's the right one. Nominations, the right order this time. Mr. Rickett. Omar Azeem. Nathan Collette. Jack Shirley. Adam Smith. But the winner, by one vote. Who do you think it is?
Reese
Amos, get out here, please. Have you seen a 4.5 pack like that before? Get up there before you pull a muscle. Okay, I'm now going to hand you over to Lyndon's most famous rapper ever. You get down for a bit of rapping there, mate. Okay? Mrs. Gibbs.
And he said, sorry, he said, there's no budget for that. He said, we're all doing this for nothing. I thought, well, fair point, after all, it's not live at the Apollo, more sort of hardly a heartbeat to the hub, really. So I decided what I do is I'll do the warm-up myself. This will involve losing touch with reality and suspending logical thinking. I think most of you are going to be all right. I think most of them are going to be all right with this one. So bear with. So, what I'm going to do is warm you up as an audience, get you all hyped up, ready for the main act, which is me. So here we go. Oh, no, but before that, I must tell you something that happened the other day. We were in the upstairs toilets, that's me and myself, right? And myself is all like snuffling and watery-eyed. So I'm like, ah, oh, what's up? That Mr. Finn been talking down to you again. No, it's just a bit of hay fever. Ah, oh, come on, what have we said to the students about not stuffing their feelings and sitting on uncomfortable emotions? What is it? I'm gonna miss the outsiders. The outsiders? What, you mean those little kids that write a school magazine? No, that's the insiders. Well, who are the outsiders then? The outsiders, year 11's outside at lunchtime. You're going to miss the year 11's, like who? Well... Hi. For a start, all the Barcelona girls and boys, including Olivia, Lauren, Ellie, Sophie, Chloe, Amy, Megan, Yasmin, Remy, Alana, Daniel Wilson, highly invoking. Can I say his stick footballers, I'm done. Including Sam, Jake, Alex, Scott, Connor, Joe and Dan on the twins. The twins? Yeah, Wickham and Gambino, you know what that called? Oh, and Cummings. Where's Cummings? Is he here today? Yay! Me and your mummy are such good friends. Yeah. Oh, and there's the in-betweeners. McQuillan. Al, Pope, Kelly, Plummer and Rose. Do you know, I thought McQuillan was being bullied. I did, didn't I, McQuillan? Do you remember that? Yeah, and then I found out he was paying them to strip him, stamp on his bag, and kick his kidneys. All of the tune of the Queen is a bad gig. Anyway, going to defeat the bowler and saying there was basketball and other respectful young men like Aaron, Humza, Khalil, Hassid, and Kirit Panasar with his Wagwan Don. You don't think they might just be taking the mick, do you? No. Oh, and I'll definitely miss Ron and Drain. So chivalrous and charming. Do you know, he offered to get that year 10 that kicked a ball in my face last year. Theo Robinson.
T-Dot.
Who never misses a fist bump. Jack Lewis, of course. Why? Because he's the number one ginge. No! Because he's so polite and well-mannered. Then there's all the girls, including Annie, Marnie, Moona, Marianne, Grace, Kalisha, the Cochin girls, Burak and Zainab, Apecha, Hen and Safa, even though Safa had a phone out the other day. How Mr. Buck Technician and I will miss the ones that scream so loudly. And then there's the Nicotinis behind a tree near you. Franks and Devney. Chris, Aaron and their absent friend. With their talk of flicking beans. And displays of simulated gay sex. They're talking to a child of the 60s. Anyway, there's Joel, Kishal, Josh, Rajan, Sandeep, Rabi, and their absent friend. I'll never forget their dining room chat up line. Hold on. Oi! Absolutely brilliant. The conservationists, you know who you are, the conservationists who kindly signed my Save the Tree petition at half term. Mr. Finn would say they were branching out. Liam Gomez, Curtis Harrison, James Webber, Harley Dacre, and later that day, Sadia Sultana. Thank you all. The tree is safe for now. It is, it is. Not to mention deep respect for the group of year 11s who hang around the fence by the field and down the science block end. They know the secret of just enjoying each other's company in friendly and social interchange. And you know, just as summer arrives, well, I thought it arrived, and Bill Al-Ahmed has taken off his gloves. They're all good. Basically, I'm going to miss them all. I can't believe you're going to miss the year 11s. I mean, it's like fraternising with the enemy. You can't actually like students. What would teachers say if they found out? I really need you to help. You need to do a rap, a warm-up for us before the rap. I really need you to. Because I'm going to feel so stupid just standing there doing this rap. It needs a bit of a wrap-around. A rap. We're doing a rap again after last year with that whole YOLO and that. We say never again. I know, I just can't help it. Well, and it's on a Friday. We don't work Fridays. We said when we turned 40, recently, that we were going to go out and get a life, didn't we? oh, come on, you've really got to help me out here. Please say you'll do it. What could I say? Anything to keep us out of that special summer clinic. Oh, hold on, getting a signal from over there. I am winding them up, isn't that what I'm doing? Wind them up. Oh God, you want me to wind it up? God, we haven't done a warm-up yet. Right, just time for a quick quiz before the wrap then. A quick quiz about Mrs. Gibbs now. What do we know? What is Mrs. Gibbs's favourite fruit? That was a bit too easy, wasn't it? Now, what about what variety of apple?
Ganja!
Someone at the back got that one. I'm Ravi, no, not Ganja. Well done. For a bonus point, what is Mrs. Gibbs's second favourite fruit?
Sausage.
Yes, good. One other.
Seven times.
Yes, thank you. At the back, well done. So, are you all now sort of warmed up, hyped up, ready for the main act? So, when we go off as me, I'll come back. As me, but I'll be doing okay, so big welcome for when I come on, because I'm a little bit nervous. Okay, thanks.
Cheer, Gibbsy!
What a one. I'll assume that you're cheering and cheering. I can't really hear what you're saying now, because the microphone's quite loud. Right, so, well, me man dems and me gal dems. Look at you, turn up trash and ready for use bashment. Still, soon be time for you to make that cool running. But before you go, I writ a little rap for you. So check my clothes. I know the words, so I know how to do this stuff. Right, now then, home dogs, as you can see, you's all bear younger than me. Remember me telling you some thoughts about some tips that you ought to consider before you leave these ends. Realise there's other charms than just wearing them nice crepes and gowns. And me don't mean them low batties. Gotta use your good brought up, see? Gotta try not to interrupt, see? Cut back on all that shiz. Show the world you know your biz. Don't go out and be a wasteman, just end up being a toleration. I don't want to hear you being bad wise. Don't hit the teeth with dog heart ways. You're okay to be big about you. Even drive a swanky car. Mash it up, be swaggerific. You think you are gonna be terrific. Gonna have pets, the amount of bling and all that sort of fancy thing. But what I don't want you to understand, I want you all to understand that no matter what else you do, the best thing you can be is you.
Thank you. I'll start yet again. Just introduce a couple of guests we've got in today. We've got Gina here from Tesco's. So give Gina a round of applause, please. You know me, I just thought every little helps, okay? Did that one last year and it went down well. And we've got our friends from the police. Can you stand up, please, officers of the New York? Detentions are out, ICE is out, you just get arrested, okay. Right, why don't we move on to the group, isn't it now? Have we got the group ready? Maggie, are you here? Right. This group was formed a long, long time ago, I think Monday afternoon actually. Is that right? Thursday morning, yesterday. And they've been rehearsing madly. For all of 10 minutes, so here we go. Give them a cheer when they get ready, not just yet, when they get ready. One of them lost the guitar this morning and were fretting like mad, I tell you. Thank you.
Nice feet.
It did strike you cool, Mrs. Gibbs, you're quite right.
Thank you.
round of applause. Thank you. Thank you, the group. We're now moving on to the girls' dance group, so give it up for the girls, please.
Yeah.
Seen from me is nothing like a good dance. Hard work that somebody's got to do. Okay, Mr. Spurs gone. Right, next lot. Mrs. Norman, please, could you come up here? Right. Moving on now to cutest couple. Some strange nominations here. Dare I say it? Ryan Burke and Ryan Brain. Ryan Brain and Rhys Amos. Rhys Amos and Ryan Burke. There's a bit of a triangle going on there. A love triangle. Rhys Amos and Aaron Croft. James Howell and Tom McQuillan. Be quite honest, I'm beginning to feel that you just completely misunderstood the nomination. Seriously. Bilal Nvetcha. Charlie and Lauren. Katie and Adam. Ian for Crisp's fame. Aisha and Nathan. Annie and Joe. I feel I must make a special mention here because one or two people have been to see me and I've done a bit of observations over the past few weeks. Harley and Olivia deserve a mention here, I feel. Right, but the winner, Mrs. Norman's got the certificate here. The cutest couple, 2013, is Sam and Claire. Shoot his wife? Tequila. Mrs. Williams has just said, what? Tequila is a... it's a beverage. Aaron. Oh, no, for improvisation there. Wish it good. Here we go. What's the next one? Best looking girl. Now, I've done quite a bit of research on this, been carrying my clipboard around as I do every year. Nominations are as follows. Ryan Burke. Rhys Amos. Ryan Bray. Aaron Croft. No, sorry, that was the wrong group. They've still got a mention there. Sydney Goodwin. Laura Jones. Lauren Smith. Molly Jerome. Lisa Herbert. Chloe Wilde. Zara Woodall. Mr. Finn. Bit harsh, I think that one, bit harsh. The best looking girl of 2013 is... Sinead! Excellent. Right, I think you got one more there, haven't you? Best looking boy. Sorry, it's a blank certificate. We haven't got any. We're moving on. I did get a couple of votes for this myself, actually. I feel quite good about that. I'm not reading the script. I'm ad-libbing at this point. Some received one vote. I think most of these votes, most of these nominations were nominated from the blind school, to be honest, but there you go. Curtis Harrison got a nomination. Aaron Croft got a nomination. Rhys Amos. We haven't looked at his body. Rip it up, will you? The winner, Scott Lyndon. Takes a biscuit, the penguin biscuit. Oh, right. Well done, Scott. Scott won the nomination by 2 votes. Very close. He got 2 votes. Sometimes I make myself smile, you know. Not very often. Right, are we going to do Julie? Is Julie here? Julie's here. Julie's going to sing for us, not my cup ready. Can we arrest those at the back there, please? Shouting in the leaves, you said. Are you enjoying yourself? Oh, right. Okay, we're going to move on. It's Mrs. Williams now again, I believe. Mrs. Williams, could you give me a hand, please? Thank you. Right, we're moving on to the award for Funniest Girl. The nominations were Leah Patrick, Zainab Anwar, I did have a word with Zainab in the corridor yesterday. She said, I've loved your lessons, so she said, it's a pity I didn't get any of your jokes. So why has Zainab been nominated? No, you're lovely, honest. Just don't get my jokes. Marnie Gallagher. Luna. Abby Parchman. With a name like her, it's time she turned over a new leaf. Zoe Gill. The winner, the funniest girl of 2013, a lovely young lady, Gemma Fleer. Funny and walked out, so it's well deserved. The funniest boy then, nominations.
Aaron Croft.
Nick Pope. Just a minute, can we get Nick Pope out the front here, please? Where's Nick Pope? Come here, come here. With a name like his, he hasn't got a prayer, has he? He's committed the cardinal sin, I tell you. There's another one. Never mind. Right, the funniest boy nominations, Ryan Burke, Oliver McNeil. I bet when you voted for some of these, you were laughing, but you're not laughing now, are you? The genuine comedian of the year 2013, I understand from your vote, is Dominic Hughes. He'll get his just desserts, I tell you. Thank you. Don't take the young one away. Right. I think we've got a dance routine now, haven't we? Olivia and Alana, are you ready, girls? We need to get this. Olivia, in front. Or... Where are you going? Olivia, where are you going to do it? Down here? Up there?
Yeah.
Up there. So, how are we going to get those back? Right, it falls upon me to fill in a gap now. Okay, it's live. I went to the butcher's this morning. It's a joint effort. I said to him, I bet you 50 quid you can't reach that beef on that top shelf. And he looked at me and said, no, steaks are too high. The stakes at best. Okay, Zainab, get on. Right. Come on, stand up here and just... No, she don't want to be in the laugh on my tip. Are we ready? Right, the other thing is, I nearly didn't get here today because stopped on the M6. Police were all over the place. Apparently a lorry load of sheep had been hijacked. I sat there for 2 hours because I came in really early this morning just to get ready for this. Anyway, after 2 hours, the police just went, go on, get going, like they always do, you know, aggressively on the motorway. Go on, get going. There's nothing there, nothing to be seen. To be honest, I think they were pulling the wool over my eyes. Are we ready?
Popular party goer for 2013 is
Becky Toby. Seeing Becky dressed as coloured pens is the highlight of my day. Thank you, Becky. The highlight of my day. Moving on. Sportswoman of the year, sportswoman of the year. Sorry, that's Sportsman of the Year, I should be saying. Sportsman of the Year. First nomination, Nick Pope. Apparently he runs every day religiously. Dan Hinks. Kashan. The next person who was nominated, you need to do some investigations because somebody put your name down on the sheet, in brackets, and his trainers. So it's Harry Hewer and his trainers. Sam Lyndon. Theo Robinson. But the overwhelming winner, Sportsman of 2013, is Jake Prince. Having a go at you, Mrs. Donald. but the overwhelming winner of Ginger of the Year 2013 is, let's hear it, Spider-Man for a minute. Is that Spider-Man?
No.